Okay, so here I'm using the yellow okra mixed with a little bit of burnt sienna. And I'm coming in and laying down a first light wash for some of the shading on her hair. I'll use the exact same color on her wings to do another light wash. And it's one of the great things about butterfly wings is that lines don't have to be completely straight and crisp like they would on, say, dragonfly wings, because of the fact that butterfly wings are actually kind of fuzzy. Like they have lots of little tiny hairs on them. So, making lines and the details a little bit fuzzy instead of crisp and perfect, just in my opinion, adds a bit to the realism. Gives them more of that butterfly texture. As you can see there on my little palette, my paint is very watered down at the moment because I know I'm going to do a lot of layering to get the look that I want. Again, I've just been using the same tone, same color, just and applying it over the top of itself to layer it up and make it darker. I've switched to a smaller brush and have gone in to put in more lines in the hair. Darken up some of the shading, add a few loose strands of hair to make it a little more realistic. Add a little detail into the eyebrows as well. And I've used the same color very lightly to put in shadows for her eyelashes that are going to come in later. Now I've switched to my detail brush there at the end. Now I'm also putting on vermilion, just straight up watered down vermilion over the top of some of the darker areas of her wings. And I'm going to put it in her hair as well to keep her hair and her wings are supposed to, tie in with each other as far as color goes. Adding a little bit of that vermilion just, gives it a little added depth instead of it all just being the same yellow shades, basically. I switch between my Aquaflow and my detail brush as needed. Alright. Now come back in with that very watered down vermilion, and I am putting in her eyelashes. And a few little extra details on her eyebrows. Now I've got just straight up black I'm coming in for her pupil. And to add a little bit of shading around the highlight and darkest part of the iris. I've mixed a little bit of sienna and Vermilion, I think it is, in there to do the, yeah, to do the darker bits on both her eyelashes there, and that's what I used on her nostrils as well. Just adding in some slightly darker lashes. I've got violet there that I'm using just a tiny drop of to help darken up her eyes a bit. And now I moved on to her shirt. I'm going in with sap green over the top. Okay, when I've got a little bit too much water, I just push it so that the pigment all ends up pooling down towards the bottom, and it just actually ends up giving it some extra easy shading. Still just working with that sap green, putting a coat everywhere. Since her shirt is supposed to be made out of leaves. All I'm doing to vary how dark some of these green bits are here is I'm just either adding more or less water as needed. Either just thinning out the paint to make a lighter wash or letting it stay thicker for a darker wash and more color. Now I'm coming back in with the deep green, which for some reason on my fire looks blue, but it's deep green. And I use that to put in the darkest shadow. Use it to deepen some of the green. I don't put it over the entire thing though, like a whole wash for the entire shirt. I just put it in where the most shadows would fall. And that's it. Now she just sits to dry and she's done.